Hi, in this video we'll be getting Dubbler set up with GarageBand. So the first thing you want to do once you've downloaded and registered the Dubbler app is follow the in-app steps to calibrate your mic and open up a blank profile. Then in the bottom right hand side, we want to make sure that inbuilt audio is off and that MIDI out is on, as we'll be controlling external instruments in GarageBand. So now back in GarageBand, we can add an instrument track. We want to make sure that we add a software instrument track, a non-audio track or a drummer track, as we're controlling the instrument with MIDI information from Dubbler. So let's hit create, and now that we have a track loaded up. Now the great thing about GarageBand is that it's really easy to set up and we don't need to change any preferences, so we can dive straight in with making some music. So the first thing we'll take a look at is using triggers to control drum sounds in GarageBand. So before we start controlling any sounds, we need to set up these triggers in Dubbler. So we can add our triggers on the left hand side here. So triggers work in that you teach Dubbler a sound and it assigns that sound to a MIDI note, which in turn will trigger the information in GarageBand. So let's add our first trigger, which will be for a kick drum sound, and hit record takes to teach Dubbler the sound we want to use. It's really important that the sound we choose here is short and sharp and not a long sound such as boom, 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 because then it won't be very accurate. So for a bass drum sound, I'm going to choose a sound. So let's record that. Let's add a second one. This is a different sound, so this will be going out to a snare. And let's add a third final trigger. So if you want, you can keep going and add up to 8 triggers, but let's just stick with those 3 for now. If you want a more in-depth guide of how to train triggers, there's a separate video on this over on our Learn Dubbler page. Now, before we start using these triggers to control some drums in GarageBand, it's important to note that although GarageBand is very easy to set up and use, the downside is that it has some limitations and doesn't support some more advanced MIDI features. So Dubbler has the capacity to send MIDI data to 2 different MIDI channels simultaneously, allow you to control one channel with triggers and another channel with pitched information at the same time if you wanted. Unfortunately, GarageBand as an entry-level digital audio workstation, or DAW, doesn't have the ability to take advantage of this feature, and instead all MIDI information in GarageBand is combined and fed directly to the active instrument. Now this doesn't prevent you from making beats and melodies in GarageBand, but to make sure no accidental notes are being sent to the active channel, we can turn off either side using these buttons at the top. So I can turn pitch off if I'm just using triggers, or I can turn triggers off if I'm just using pitch. So as we're going to use these triggers to control some drums, let's make sure the pitch side of Dubbler is turned off. So now in GarageBand, we can choose the instrument that we want to control with those triggers. So in the library in the top left-hand side here, let's go to Electronic Drum Kit and just choose one of these at the top. Make sure the track isn't muted or anything, but I can now use those triggers to hear it back in that drum machine. If I want to record this MIDI information, I can simply hit record at the top here and lay down that beat. And now you can see that MIDI information is there, and I can edit it at the bottom or press play to hear it back. So let's delete this and now take a look at how to control pitched instruments in GarageBand. So the first thing, as I mentioned before, in Dubbler, we're going to turn the triggers off and now turn the pitch side on. Also, now that pitch is on, we want to make sure we're in a key lock of your choice, so we're in a C major, and we're now ready to go. So in GarageBand, let's choose an instrument we want to control. So again, let's go to synth and let's choose a pad from here. We'll do a classic analog pad. So in GarageBand, I can now simply sing or hum a melody and hear it back in that synth. Ba, ba, ba. And the same as the drums, if I hit record, I can record that MIDI information in. Ba, ba, ba. If I double click, I can edit that at the bottom, or if I want, I can go back and record over it. I can also do chords in exactly the same way. So back in Dubbler, we can turn chords on here, and I can simply sing those in. So in Dubbler on the right hand side, you'll also see these control dials, but unfortunately another limitation is that GarageBand doesn't facilitate MIDI CC mapping, so these can't be used to control parameters on the instrument you have. It also has a fixed buffer size, and therefore the audio latency in GarageBand, which is longer than in some DAWs, can't be changed. But if you want to start taking your music making further and take advantage of these more advanced MIDI features, we recommend testing out other advanced DAWs such as Logic, Ableton, or FL Studio. So that's the basics of how to get Dubbler set up with GarageBand, but if you want to find out more and go in depth with each section of Dubbler, make sure to check out the Learn Dubbler page on the website.